Hello everyone. This is the second tutorial on projection modeling. I'll show you how to connect the projection mesh, how to combine mesh and curves, and finally about the projection text. Firstly, you have two options. You can do it like here, fill the plane with faces. Do not forget about the Z-axis of the plane. Or you can leave a contour. Only each contour must be closed, and you must not have edges between the contours. Here's what happens if you don't remove the edge. You can just remove it and do it again. So, you have an object made from two mesh projections. Buttons for setting the Z axis and origin rotation also work on the mesh plane. Go into projection editing mode and manipulate your 3D model. Can be scaled on top of other parts of the projections. Such moments will be combined on the model. But if edges or vertices overlap, this may cause errors. When you fill faces, extrude, or anything else, it changes in real time on your model. You can make a hole by removing the face. Most likely I made it crooked. You can use a magnet on the points of another projection to align them with each other. Let's look at another example. You don't need to build a mesh before creating a projection object. When created, it will clear your projection objects from the mesh of unnecessary geometry. You can control the projection, but don't forget to put points where they are needed. I think this modeling method still gives much more, even in such simple things. You don't need to allocate a bunch of geometry. The only errors that can occur are associated with such edges. You can dissolve them. But first make a smooth edge somewhere else. Oh, here she is. Be careful. I was lucky that I was able to show you this problem. Now it won't take you by surprise. Yes, then you already understand everything that can be done with the mesh. You can do it here too. Now I will show you that this can be done easier. You can simply create a plane, change its size, and add it to the desired collection of projections. Select the desired collection and select the object, add. Now that it is already in the collection, you can duplicate it and do whatever you want with it. If you want to move it to another collection, you can remove it from the collection by selecting it in the list and then add it to another collection. Yes, since they intersect, it turns out to be a shelf. Everything is up to your imagination. Now I'll show you how you can combine curves and what a plus it gives. If you watch the additional tutorial about working with curves, you will understand how I did it. I think my grandma had something here that wouldn't let her roll over. Just add this to the collection too. I don't think my legs are long enough. Yes, these are curves you can adjust the grid. I love curves. You can use the plus button to add several. You can use the plus button to add several objects at once, be it a mesh or curves, to the collection of projections. You should also know that when creating a projection object, the active object goes into the first collection, and the selected one or a group of selected objects goes into the second collection. Now I will show the text. It's possible to make a second projection from a mesh, but I missed the curves. Well, that's it. You can create a projection object. You can adjust the grid, both on the curve and on the letters. Change the text, but it's better to turn off the projection object to make it easier. You can also convert the text into a curve and bend the letters as you want. Thank you all for watching. I hope this video will help you in your work. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to write to me.